Would you believe that 3 out of every 4 decisions you make are related to consumption alone? Sounds surprising, but it is true. Even the choice of tea or coffee after breakfast is also your privilege. Choose one product over the other, no one knows better than you do. Each person, just like you and me, who buys goods for personal consumption is a consumer. And the entire group of such consumers makes the consumer market. Can't we do it without buying? Practically no. Buy we must, seldom realizing how deeply we involve ourselves in deciding upon things that we consume. No matter whether it is an essential item or an item meant for comfort or luxury. Let us take this as an example.
I am planning to buy a fridge because it is a necessity.
I just can't cook twice a day. I don't have the time and energy for it, so I need a fridge.
I have time. I don't want to cook twice a day. It's so tiring. I need a fridge.
My wife has been pestering me for a long time to buy a fridge. After a long and tiring day, I can't bear another argument at home, so I want a fridge.
Why not? When all my neighbors have a fridge, why shouldn't I?
We don't need a fridge. We need calling.
Once the need is recognized, the search begins.
I want to buy a fridge, but the problem is lot of brand available in the market. I wish to decide only after going through all the literature.
I've just moved into a place of my own and I need to buy a new fridge. And I would want something good and something sturdy. And I think my friends know a lot about refrigerators, so I would take their suggestion and buy one.
I can't afford to buy an expensive fridge. I need something priced moderately.
As I am in a transferable job, the fridge which I need is, that should be very compact, rugged, that can be transported very easily and should be light.
I want a fridge. I saw an ad in the newspaper and I was quite convinced with the ad. Moreover, I've had a talk with my friend. She's got the same fridge and she's quite happy with the working of it.
There are some who would like to depend upon their personal knowledge and experience.
I have been using the fridge for 20 years. It's not a new product for me. I don't have to depend upon anybody or anybody's comments. I will make my own choice. I know which one to buy.
For our grandson, we would like to purchase the same type of fridge we have been using for years. It is so dependable, trustworthy and trouble-free.
I want a medium-sized fridge by evening. Can you deliver? Brands, money. That's not the problem, but it should be the best piece you have available now.
I want a 165-liter capacity refrigerator. It should be able to withstand voltage fluctuations. It should have an auto defrost, a very silent compressor, and the power consumption should be very low.
But will the search go on endlessly?
No, that is not possible. After all,
consumer's time, energy and money are limited. But his efforts will always be in proportion to the expected gains from the product or service. As an economic man, the consumer attempts to achieve the maximum amount of benefits from his or her actions. The consumer is always purposeful and goal-oriented. Naturally, his or her actions have reasons.
This raises an issue. What kind of a person is this consumer? What motivates his behavior in the marketplace? And what makes the consumer what he is?
Could be virtually endless. Consumer behavior is an outcome of several events occurring at different points of time. In fact, it is a process, and in this process, buying is the only observable fact.
I don't mind paying a little extra for a good fridge. After all, you don't buy these things every day.
Well, I've just started my career now and I would like to go in for a fridge. The two important factors which will help me decide which fridge I go in for are one, that it should last longer, and two, that it should be backed by guarantee.
I will choose a brand that ensures prompt after-sales service.
Naturally, each consumer has his own reason, but his behavior is also influenced by geographical location.
Fridge, here in Pahalgam. We can do without it in whole of Kashmir.
Immediate economic condition.
I want to buy a fridge right now. I have made some money through shares.
Cultural background.
I am a vegetarian. I want to buy a fridge without the tray for keeping eggs, because that is lost space for me.
And the marketing environment.
Up till now, I haven't got any fridge. When I have come to this market, I've seen many shops are selling fridge. I want to purchase one.
Ask any marketer. He'll tell you how important it is for him to know his clientele and their behavior. And how does he go about it? Naturally, his approach remains as individualistic as his own personality. Unless the marketer tries to probe what kinds of inputs the consumer holds within himself, how can he modify his own product offer? It is very important to try to read the consumer's mind. Without this exercise, no one can get any clue to his thoughts or actions. The more a marketer knows about the consumer, the better he can sell them.
Well, it is never possible to make a perfect prediction. But can we do without any prediction either?
Some effort to discover a little bit more about the consumers always continues. You may verify this fact from any marketer, successful or not so successful. They will tell you that it significantly lowers the chances of product failure or improves the chances of product success. And that is what makes or breaks a business.
Here is an unique situation.
खरीद सकते हैं।
Faced with such puzzles. Who is the actual consumer? Is it the person who initiated the idea or the one who influenced it? Or is the decider the consumer? Some may guess it is the person who is finally going to pay for the equipment. And others may feel it is the one who would use it most often. Such situations encourage a marketer to study the family as a consuming unit. Coming back to the point, we discover that consumer behavior varies from person to person. It would be maddening to try to understand every single individual.
But out of the whole set, if we can identify a cluster of people who behave in a similar fashion, have common traits or experiences, then we can approach them in a specific and specified manner. This is also known as segmentation. Such segmentation in practice actually makes the job of a marketer possible. And perhaps easier.
Let us try to recapitulate some essential points.
Let me caution you that plain and uncritical reliance on research can have some unfavorable consequences too. Research is important, but any decision with regard to consumers has to be blended with experience and creativity.